Let's give a warm Baltimore welcome for John Mayer.
Thank you. matter of being sane to some degree. And what about this feeling that I'm never good enough? Will it wash out in the water, or is it always? I didn't relax inside me just to say this fast someone. Will I let this woman kill me? I threw it with jealous love. Will it wash out the water? Or is it always in the water? I can't.
Who says I can't get stoned? Who says I can't get stoned?
beat our heads on the county line, and we don't think to set aside. Who says I can't take time? It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long night in Berlin too. I don't remember you looking any better. But when you came, I don't remember you. Oh, how do you do?
Free fall.
Dear Marie, tell me where you once I used to be. Oh, dear Marie, tell me where you once I used to be. And if you're further up the road, can you show me where I still can't see? Remember me. I'm the boy you used to love when you were 15. Remember me. I'm the boy you used to love when we were 15. And now I wonder what you think when you see me in a magazine. From time to time, I go looking for your photograph online. From time to time, I go looking for your photograph online. Some kind of judging will have us all I ever find.
There goes my night. Suddenly your night, it's directed by a new director. New film director. Goes a little emo, becomes the Notebook. I was just looking to watch a TV show. And I'm rethinking everything I've ever done. This is the night for that. And we're all taking care of each other. We all have to go do that. I love you too. I know that sounded really curt, but I had a thought. I needed to both say I love you too and retain the thought. I mean, I love you too. I was on the losing end of that deal in my mind.
Can't take this deep.
Maybe not.
Yippee.
It was the most gripping tale I ever told on stage. Tenuous relationship with the big songs I've had. And I haven't had that many big songs in my career. I don't lack as much self-confidence as you might think. I'm a healthy amount. I don't have it where it counts. I'm lovable then. I wasn't lovable for a very long time. That's stuff I had to run. I had to run. And then I went like this. Okay. Someone else do this, John. I believe you, someone else. But I have a strange relationship with the quote-unquote hits. Because I've always had the hits I've had were quote-unquote hits. They weren't necessarily atomic bombs of hit songs.
Just sing
they were
it.
These strange little outliers that like poke through the world and people would know about them. And that was fun. And like, sometimes I think just on account of them being quote-unquote hits, they're no good anymore or something, they're used up. Or because they were hits, they somehow lack some genetic information that makes them a little deeper than the rest of the music band. I'm gonna play one anyway. If only to see how it makes me feel. And it goes like this. It's actually fun because in a world of tracks and beats and loops and plugins, this song is just me and the guitar. As soon as the guitar starts playing, you're like, there's that song.
Like a maze, but all of the walls are unconcealed.
By the culture and the society and the friend circle, that he has the ability to be able to have sex with anything it sees. That somehow being a man allows you to summon the ability to have sex. And when they can't, because you're not supposed to, they get horribly scared and shaken and traumatized by the reality that no, men don't naturally have that. We're told that every female you see, you should be able to, at any moment, be able to. And so we go into those situations and we think we're able to, because that's the woman, I'm a man, that's what men do, and we fail. And we have all had those failures in our past sexual lives. And that's the trauma, is the failure to try to be able to be present sexually for every woman, because that's the woman, I'm a man, that's what they said we would be. We think we're alone, we're the only person who can't do it. And we're shit scared in every future relationship, in every future interaction. So we look at alcohol, and we go, that's gonna help me do it. That's gonna help me get through this divide. And the divide is that you're not interested in this person. You can't, this is not the person for you. But we say to ourselves as men when we're younger, well, there's something wrong with me. We have to close this gap. I'm gonna drink, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. And it leads to more and more compounding sexual trauma. Because when you drink, you also can't have sex. So what do men do? We get deeper and deeper and deeper into a hole. And this idea that masculinity is tough and strong and gruff and alpha is the world's biggest lie. We are deeply traumatized and frightened at the idea that we can't live up to the male contract, that the male contract is bullshit. It's bullshit. The male contract that is bullshit is the idea that if you're a man, any woman you see, you should be able to get an erection. And when we don't, that's the trauma. That I don't want it to be the male contract. I'm telling you that's the contract, and we have to tear the contract up. And we have to tear it up. What's that? No, it doesn't. This is fine. She's actually asking a really decent, pertinent question. What you're saying, what is the male contract then? The male contract is to, at between the ages of whatever, puberty and college, to be instructed, to have a class, to have a voice of reason taught to young men. You are not supposed to be able to do this to everything that moves. You are not entitled to be able to do this to everything that moves. This does not come naturally to a man. This does not come unnaturally to a man. You do not possess the universal ability to have any woman that you see. They're scared and you're scared. And I'm just going on record as revealing the trauma of men feeling like they've fallen short of a bullshit alpha male contract that nobody can live up to. And until we get rid of that in men, we won't have the life that we all deserve. And I'm sorry for taking up your time to be able to say that. I don't think it's controversial. I think it's the truth. And I don't want to send fathers big into your daughters and walk away without adding that amendment in this day.
We're gonna carry on, but I want to take a minute to say that that might have been a good point, but that this was not the place to say it. So hold on. I think you should be allowed to say something and not have to wait a night and a day and tweet it. Right? It's not the right place for it. So I apologize to you if I put you off. It's not necessary. I think it's cool to say something, take a beat and go, maybe not the spot for it. I think that's okay. I think if you catch it early, you go, maybe I'm out of place. Because I'm out of place, so I apologize for that. But I want you to know I'm thinking about you and I care about us very much. I want to thank Paul Smith from Paul Reed's Smith Guitar. And I want to thank Fallin, I want to thank the great work of the people at Johns Hopkins Hospital for having me here. It's something I've wanted to do for a while. And the timing works out now, so thank you very much. You guys are like my friend. And then we're hanging out a little bit.
Can't be a major man.
memories to hold her down. It's hard for me to take a stand, but I will take them any way that I can. Oh, you know she comes and she goes like no one can. She comes and she goes. She's a man through my head. She's always present, just like neon, 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 neon. Who knows how long, how long, how long she can only fall.
Thank you, brother. A couple more songs to do for you. So this is the opposite of Daughters, because this song needs a lot of track, and a lot of beats, and a lot of plugins, and a lot of computer. But it's nice to have a big song after about 10 minutes.
Take a ride. the hardest life that's running through my veins for you.
Now this might be the part of the song.
Just stop.
Where I realized there's no ending to this song. It fades out. So I'll have to play it forever.
Waiting on the world to change. Back down the wall up here.
just trying to look for the truth in the world and things. And this is a song that I wrote in trying to find the truth of late in life parent divorce, which is a real thing. If anyone ever had their parents get divorced in their 30s or 40s, it's tougher than you think. Everyone thinks, you're a adult by now, you got it. But this is me, back in 2010, trying to find the truth in that. And it's called Born and Raised.
Hard to take in games, hard to fake what I won't be.
Go on.